Global Sports with Kim Tuohy at 6, 10, and 11 on Global Saskatoon.
Good morning. It's 8:30 Monday, December 5th. You're watching the morning news on Global Saskatoon. Here's some top stories. Back to business. MLAs return to the legislature with the throne speech coming down today. And NDP leadership hopefuls square off. And now the debate's over who won.
Live from the Global Saskatoon studios, the morning news with Lisa Dutton and Warren Dean.
Thanks so much for joining us, Warren, and I are so happy to be back on the desk with you. A beautiful shot of Saskatoon.
It's always nice in the morning when the sun starts coming up, and we're going to get to those days. The days will start lengthening out daylight-wise coming up on the 21st. That's when we hit the official winter season.
Yeah.
So we only have a couple more weeks of everything crunching down on us, and then we'll start lengthening the daylight hours out, which is good. Now, if we switch to daylight savings time,
yeah,
it would be different. But
there's an idea.
We won't get into that debate. There's enough to cover today. there you see a wonderful shot. Traffic flowing very nicely. We do have one accident to tell you about. Avenue T North and Bedford Road. So avoid that area if you can. It might delay you a little bit on your drive this morning. Minus 12 in Saskatoon. We will see that sunshine. And not only will it warm up this afternoon, but it'll warm up tonight. Details coming up with Sky Tracker Weather. Lisa?
All right, thanks, Warren. And we begin our news segment now with a big story out of Alberta, where two Mounties are recovering from gunshot wounds after they were hit during a police standoff southwest of Edmonton. It happened early yesterday outside a rural residence about 18 kilometers west of Breton. Global's Linda Nguyen reports.
This incident does show the dangers that face police every day.
A convoy of police vehicles leaves the scene after a tense standoff that left two RCMP officers shot and three other people injured.
The roads were blocked and there was a bunch of officers up the road.
Breton RCMP were called Saturday evening after reports a 35-year-old man had been shot outside a rural residence about 18 kilometers west of the community. Officers from surrounding detachments, the police dog team, and RCMP emergency response members were called in to assist as police worked to secure the residence and make contact with the people inside the home.
Neighbors surrounding or around the residence were evacuated to ensure public safety. And negotiations with the people inside the residence continued throughout the night.
At 3:30 Sunday morning, police say there was a gunfire exchange between police and the unknown individuals inside the residence. Two Red Deer RCMP officers from the emergency response team were shot and injured. Both were flown to hospital by Stars Air Ambulance.
The individual with 10 years of service had superficial injuries, and at this point, I believe he's still in hospital. The 30-plus year member has a little bit more serious injuries. However, I'm told it's